Hi, I am Rohit. You may know me as a React Native and Expo developer, but I also started learning Next.js. Yes, I am learning web development. I will show you how to learn something from scratch by following the official documentation without buying a paid course. And yes, I am still learning, so I may make mistakes. Please feel free to correct me. You can comment here or join me on my social media handles. Follow me or DM me, whatever you prefer. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. Without knowing anything, I went to Google and searched React. The official website pops up at the top of the search list. Go to this website and click on Learn React. You will see a quick start guide, but we don't want that because we don't know anything and we will start with installations. Click on installations and click on start a new React project. You can see that you need to install Node.js for local development. Go to the download page and install any of the Node.js versions available. LTS stands for long-term support, so I recommend installing the Node version 18.17.1. However, you are free to install the latest version. I have already installed Node because I have been building React Native apps for a long time. My version is 16.17.1 and it works fine. Production grade React framework, Next.js. Next.js is a full-stack React framework. It's a versatile and lets you create React apps of any size, from a mostly static blog to a complex dynamic application. Yes, we are new to Next.js, so click on the Next.js tutorial link. You can pause the video and read the documentation if you like, but I will try to summarize it. This tutorial is designed for people who have some knowledge of HTML, CSS and JavaScript, but no knowledge of React. If you don't know anything about React, you can read the About Next.js section of the documentation. I have built some React Native apps, so I will skip that section. If I have any problems, I will follow the documentation from here. From the left hand side, click on the Create a Next.js app. Let's create our first app using the command shown in the official docs. I made a separate folder and inside that folder, open the command terminal window by tapping cmd in the nav bar. Next, initialize the Next.js app using the command npx create next app myapp. Here myapp is the name of the app we are building. By default, the React will ask you some questions. Would you like to use TypeScript? No, because I use JavaScript most of the time. Would you like to use ESLint? Yes, ESLint is an open source project that helps you find and fix problems with your JavaScript code. Would you like to use Tailwind CSS? No, we will start from the scratch. No source directory for now, so no. Would you like to use app router? I don't know what is this, so no. No customization for now, so no. React will take a few seconds to install the dependencies. One more thing, I forget to tell you to install Visual Code Studio. If you are already using it, that's great. But if you aren't, please install it. You can also use Sublime Text or Atom Text Editor if you prefer. I opened the app in my code editor. It has so many directories and files, so I decided to run the project first before messing with them. I did this by running the official command npm run dev. After opening port 3000 in the browser, this is what I got. Okay, it doesn't look so cool, but that's fine. Now I want to customize this page. So I headed back to the Next.js website and click on the docs link. The docs started with the Next.js introduction. If you scroll on a bit, you will see a section on the app router versus pages router. The app router is a newer router that allows you to use React's latest features. However, when we installed the project, we did not allow our app to use the app router. As a result, our application is set to use the pages router. You can find the Next.js documentation for the pages router here, but we will be using the app router, don't worry. If you go to the project directory, you will see that we have a directory called pages. But before messing up anything, we want more information, right? So I went to the installation section of the docs. You can see that the docs have the installation guide we just went through. If you scroll down a bit, you will see a section named Creating Directories. We will use the app router, so we have to create an app directory. And inside that, we have to add two files, layout.js and pages.js. According to the docs, if you use the app router, the pages router is optional and the public folder is also optional. To make our project less complicated, I deleted some directories. Now create an app directory inside the root directory and inside that add two files layout.js and pages.js. Copy the code provided by the officials and paste it into the respective files. Now we need to restart our application. Okay, we got the Hello Next.js output on the 3000 port. Let's customize it a bit. Customize the header and add a paragraph text. Alright, now let's understand the project structure. This will be quick. First, we have top level folders such as apps, pages, public and source. Currently, we have only the app folder. The public folder is used to store static data such as images. Let's add a public folder to our project. We will play with it later. Next, we have top level files. As per my knowledge, don't mess up with these files if you are a beginner like me. First, we have next.config.js. It's a configuration file for Next.js. Next, we have package.json for project dependencies and scripts. You can read about all these one by one if you want. Next, we have app routing conventions. These are the default file names you can add inside the app root. All these serve different functionality. You can read more about the file structuring if you want. But we will go through all these in the upcoming videos, so make sure to hit the subscribe button and stay updated. Okay, that's it for today. In this video, we learned about how to set up our Next.js application, use app routing, and create our first static app, Hello Next.js. We also customized our app a bit and looked at the project structure. If I make any mistakes or you have a better way to approach the problem, please don't hesitate to comment or DM me on my social media handles. And yes, I will continue to make videos on Next.js learning, so make sure to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching and see you soon.